to look at identifying the value of a digit. Now, if you look at numbers, right, and you have, sometimes you have a decimal point right here, and you have maybe a 1 right here, okay, and then maybe you have a 3, and let's say a 6, or a, I don't know, let's go with an 8. And sometimes on the other side you have 7 and 2, say. You have all these different numbers in different places. Okay, so we've already looked at place value. You know what place value is, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay, so place value is something that we've already looked at, so we know what it is. So we can tell what these are. So what place value is this one right here? This one right here just before the decimal point? That's the ones place value, right? Okay, so if we know that that's the ones, then what place value is this one here?
Tens.
That's the tens, that's right. And what about this one right here?
Hundreds.
Hundreds. And do you know this one?
Th. Thousands.
Thousands, that's right. Okay, and if we had another one here, what would it be?
The 10,000.
10,000s, right? So you get the
10.
TTH. TTH. And then maybe you have 100,000s right here.
HTH.
HTH. You got lots of them, and they keep on going forever, don't they?
Yeah, okay. Numbers never end.
Okay, now interestingly, on the other side of the decimal point, it's like the opposite. It's like this is like the middle right here. Okay, and on this side right here, this is the tenths. So we write it with a 1 and let's say T for tenths, right?
Okay.
And this one here is the hundredths, right? We'll learn more about those in fractions and decimals.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Now, if we know that, we know, well, what is the value, let's say, of any one of these numbers? If we say, well, what about the 6 here? What's the value of that 6? What place value is it?
The hundreds.
That's in the hundreds, so this is actually not 6 at all. This is what? 600, right?
600.
Yeah, so that 6 there is actually worth 600. Okay, so we got to remember that. Okay, so if we're now looking at this question right here, we're being asked the digit 4 in which number represents the value of 400. So we got to look at these numbers down here and we got to say, well, In which one of these does 4 mean 400? Does 4 mean 400 in this one here? What does the 4 in this mean?
Thousands.
Well, that's more than thousands, right?
400.
That 4 means 400,000, doesn't it?
400,000.
And what does the 4 in this one mean?
466.
Ah, this 4 is 400s, right? What about this 4 here?
Four tens.
So we're looking for one that represents a value of 400. So which option are we looking for?
Two comma 466.
So 2,466 is what we're looking at. Okay. Shall we look at another problem?
Yep.
Okay. So we're going to look at another problem next. Okay. So this one here. Okay. Is look at the 6. What value does the 6 represent in this number here? If we look at this number, 485,671, what does the 6 represent?
The 6 represents the hundreds.
6. So how many hundreds?
600.
600. So we type down 600 right there. Okay. Is this starting to make sense?
Yep.
Do you think you can try it for yourself?
Yeah.
All right, you try this one. So what is the place value of 8 in 81,374? What's the place value?
I think that's in the 10,000s.
Okay, so that one's, if we look here, right, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. So that one must be in the 10,000s, right? Nice job. Nice going. Okay, one more. What the digit 5 in which number represents a value of 50?
50.
Where does the digit 5 represent a value of 50?
50? I can...
Okay, you go and click on it. Nice job. Okay. Okay, so I think you get it now, and I think you can go onto your account. I'll assign it to you, and you can try it for yourself, okay? Thanks, Killian.